Hey there everyone, Hitesh here, back again with another video, and in this video, we're gonna again talk about the payment gateways. In this video, I will introduce you the top 10 payment gateways that you can use in your upcoming projects. Now, by no means, this is a list about one being the best or 10 being the best. No, it's not like that. I just wanted to introduce the 10 payment gateways that will help you to take payments from your clients. Now, during this entire process, I will show you some of these payment gateways, pros and cons, and will compare based on my personal experience. First and foremost, is this video biased? Yes, of course. Everything is biased in this world. Some people like saturated colors. Some people like flat colors. Those who like saturated colors will always be biased towards saturated colors. So I am biased towards some of these payment gateways, which had me the great experience. Some of them, I didn't like it. So yeah, everything is biased in the world. The second thing, is this video sponsored by any of the payment gateways? No, not at all. They didn't approach me. They didn't ask me to make such videos. But if you would like to sponsor my channel, I would love to have you. Now, I will introduce these 10 payment gateways, and I will talk on to the 5 points on each and every payment gateway here. The first is onboarding process. It's not like you can just directly create an account and start accepting payment. There's a lot of paperwork that goes back and forth, your tax information, your account information, some legal information as well. So how is the onboarding process? The second one, and by the way, if you're looking where I'm looking at my notes that I made for this particular video. It's hard to remember all of these 5 points. The second is the pricing option. Pricing means if you're still thinking everything in the world is free, you need to grow up and you need to start paying your bills. These payment gateway also charges you some amount of money for their services. So that's what we are be looking up. Then after that, we'll be looking up for the documentation. If you're using anything like Shopify, WordPress, then you don't need to worry about the documentation part. You can simply just place your API keys and that's pretty much it. But if you are a developer who is looking up to integrate these payment gateway using something like Node.js, Django, PHP, or any other tech stack, documentation is pretty important for us. The fourth point is payment option and user interface. If you are living in the United States or Canada, you just have a card to pay your bills. But in India, we have a variety of options. We use credit cards, debit cards, internet banking, some wallets, and recently government introduced UPI as well. Amazing way of making payments. So we have to look forward for that as well. And fifth, the most important is the reports. Report simply means that how the graphs and charts are looking up once all the payments are being done, how the information is displayed to me so that I can compare where my business is going onto the top side or lower side. So these are gonna be 5 points on which we'll be comparing quickly onto all of these payment gateways. So sit back, enjoy, and let's get started with the payment gateways. So I've got these payment gateways for you. Let me show you up them here. Okay, and by no means this is a payment gateway like comparison of which one is first, which one is last. No, these are all the options. Pros and cons are always there. So we're gonna start our this top 10 list with the Stripe. Now Stripe is one of the most industry standard payment gateway loved by every single developer. The simple reason is on their website also, they just openly state this, that they are developer first. So obviously we love them a lot. And in fact, handling all of these into just an object is like so simple. And this was the first payment gateway that made everything so simplified and talked about the developers here. So everybody just loved that. But there are a couple of issues here. Now, at the bottom, you might see that this is a website for United States. You can switch to the Indian site as well. But still, I would say the Stripe is in the very early phase for India. They do support a lot of credits and debit cards, but still a lot of information and a lot of things needs to be done properly here. So let's quickly compare with them. Onboarding process, it's still not as easy as it should be. So I would say give it some couple of more years. It will be amazing, but I love their user interface and all of that. The pricing, very competitive, and you're gonna notice the same kind of pricing for all of that. 2% and 3% is like the standard, but the international is very expensive. And I'll tell you the reason why that is. They have a lot of fraud protection there. So the cards which are being stolen, if sometimes they are being used on their website, they actually handle it pretty nicely. They have a huge database of that. And that is the reason why they charge a little bit more for the international. Now, these are the standard pricing. If your business is doing more like above 1 crores in a year, then surely you can ask for their special pricing. all of these payment gateways have their hidden pricing for the business and enterprise as well. So you can just lower it down. In some cases, I have seen getting these pricing lowered down. I should actually not point that. That would not be fair to leak that kind of inside information. Okay, let's leave that. So onboarding is great. Pricing is very competitive. Documentation, best in the industry. You won't be finding anything near that. Payment option and user interface. Payment option side, it's lagging a little bit yet. User interface, the best in the industry. Like, this is the gold standard of how the user interface should be. And the reporting, again, top notch. Although the graphs and charts are a little bit missing, but I would say still are really great. Moving forward on to our second candidate here, PayPal. Now, PayPal is well known for all of the countries, and recently PayPal is trying to get its hands and feet and everything in India as well. Everybody wants a little bit piece from India as well now because of our huge population. So PayPal is getting up here, but what I've noticed here that their onboarding process is a little bit painful still for India. There's a lot of documentation that goes through and forth, and sometimes either their staff is not well trained, they keep you asking for the documentation that you don't even have, and you have already submitted all the legal documentations and everything, but still, I think the staff is a little bit under-trained for the verification process, so that's why it makes onboarding a bit pain. And the pricing, again, it's very competitive, just like exactly same 2%, 3% kind of a stuff there. Documentation, pretty amazing. Payment option, this is where it's lagging a little bit. It just gives you the card to pay the things. Not much of the UPIs and wallets. It's not really that much there. User interface, I would say probably the worst. They need to work a lot on how the Stripe and all these other payment gateways are doing as their user interface for payment options. The reports, pretty okay. I wouldn't give it more than 3-star out of 5. It's not really that great. I didn't enjoy PayPal, but still I do have PayPal accounts and I work through that. It's kind of an international standard, but to be very active in India, it's going to take probably a couple of more years. Let's move forward. Then we have the Indian giant, which is Paytm. Now, I would say Paytm is the victim of its own success. It's really the amazing payment gateway. They have so many of the options. But nowadays, what they are doing is their onboarding process is a little bit trickier. They have a huge number of client base. A lot of people are working. So that's why the onboarding process is it takes sometimes months to just even get started for that. Pricing wise, definitely they are very, very competitive. But a couple of things which I don't like about their pricing is why there is a limit of 20,000 for beginners to have the credit and debit cards. What if my business grows more than 20,000? Just charge whatever you like to charge, but why there is a limit up here? So make sure you read all of these things before onboarding with any of these clients. Surely they are pretty amazing. Their charging and everything is pretty dope, but I really don't like it. Let's just say I invest 50,000 in my advertisement and I'm getting a sale of 25,000. So I need to get up on the call with these guys and What is this? I really don't think this is something I'm super happy about it. But again, their payment options, they provide you a lot of options for the payment, especially all the cards, net bankings, and all the wallets. They provide you almost all of them. User interface, pretty decent. I'll give 3.5-star out of 5 to their user interface. And their reports is okay. Again, 3-star for the reports out of 5, of course. Then comes up this new guy, which is RazorPay, and I love these guys. It is also, the company was actually initially registered in my hometown as well, then they eventually moved to Bangalore. Now, for the RazorPay, I would say they looked onto the Stripe, they said, wow, Stripe is so good, but it's missing some of the things. We're gonna fix those missing things, and we just came up with the RazorPay. They have amazing UI interface and everything. So let's talk about the onboarding process is pretty easy, but they work only with the current accounts. You cannot operate with this company if you are having a saving account or you just want to test out your business. So in that case, if you just want to try with the saving account, this is not a payment gateway for you. The pricing, absolutely competitive. And you're gonna notice that their pricing, they say it's 2% and 3%. No set of fees, no annual maintenance. So it's pretty likey-likey stuff there. The documentation, top-notch in the industry, just onto the exact same level as the Stripe. Their payment options, they provide you almost everything that you need. User interface, absolutely dope. 5 out of 5 stars in the payment user interface part. The reports, absolutely good. So good. I just love them. They provide you all the charts and everything so nicely. Still, the reporting part can be improved a little bit more. And if they can provide you some app or something like that, that would be like next level thing. But no complaints here. They are already doing a great job. They have a lot of products as well. Like they have this Third Watch, and they have X Club, RazorPay X routes, and all of the things, payment splitting and bunch of other things. Moving further, another competition for the RazorPay is the PayUMoney. Now, PayUMoney, I would say their onboarding process, it's a little bit tricky, but it's not going to take months, probably like a week or something. They want everything to be signed and scanned and stuff like that. So it probably is going to take like 2 to 3 days, or probably sometimes more than a week to get onboarded. Pricing exactly same as the RazorPay, but their way of writing is a little bit different. They say it's 2% of setup and everything. And at the bottom, they say is with a hidden line, 1% extra on MX and internationals. So yeah, I'll forgive them for this kind of a stuff. This is just marketing. Nothing bad is going on there. So again, onboarding is pretty decent, not like really the best, could be improved, but pretty decent. Pricing wise, again, competitive. Their documentation, again, top notch, really as in the same bar of Stripe, RazorPay, and PayUMoney. Again, are really nice, but some of the things are tricky in the documentation, but again, I'll not go into that much of the depth. Their payment option, again, they provide you all the wallets, net banking, pretty much everything that you expect. User interface, pretty nice as well, no problem there as well. Reporting is something which is not really up to the mark in the PayUMoney. They will take a couple of more years in improving their reporting, especially on the side where they put up the graphs and charts. It's not much there. Not of a deal-breaking stuff, but yeah, pretty okay. Now, one thing which is getting a lot of attention these days is Insta Mojo. Again, another payment gateway. Now, they have a pretty good way of onboarding process. You can just enter your tax information, your bank details, and that's pretty much it. You can be onboarded like within hours, probably less than hour. And the pricing, again, very competitive, exactly same as PayUMoney or RazorPay. They just charge you 3 rupees extra per transaction, but again, I'll forgive for that, no big deal. And their documentation, pretty good, nothing to be complained about. Documentation pretty good. Their payment option, everything is there. User interface, pretty nice, no problem there. The reporting is something which they are lagging a little bit. If they introduce more graphs and charts and visualization part, that would be great. Now, the thing with the Insta Mojo is that they work with the saving account. You don't need to have a checking account or something. You just need to have a bank account, then they start working for that. But when I was using it, probably like 2 years ago, their failure rate was pretty high. And their transaction, like they follow the T+3, like when the transaction is made, we will transfer you the payment on T+3 days. That is now reduced. They have a pretty good words now, but again, things can be a little bit tricky. Of course, this is the experience from 2 years ago. Now they have improved a lot. I haven't tested them out after that. Now, one of the new guy or fairly new competition in the market is the Cashfree. Now, all of my friends who do the business of this online t-shirt selling and all of them are using Cashfree. They say their onboarding process is like breeze. The pricing is absolutely competitive. If you look at that, very, very competitive. They provide you a lot of payment option. Thing is, I haven't actually worked with their documentation yet, but to make this video, I was preparing or I was looking into their documentation. Didn't found it like as intriguing as other payment system. It's just okay, but they have a lot of confusing things up here. I think it would take a separate day or two, probably a week, to understand their documentation. But since all of my friend uses things like Shopify or WordPress, they just need an API key. Just put it up and there we go. The user interface, pretty decent, won't give like 5 stars, but 4 stars is fine for the user interface. And the reports is just okay. It needs to be improved, but it's okay. And again, they work for all the, they have no restrictions about like current account or saving account. They just accept all of that. Pretty decent, pretty fairly new. Now, I would like to introduce you the big dog in the market, which is CC Avenue. Now, CC Avenue is one of the big dog in the payment gateway industry. None of the brand that I've said so far actually comes near to it, except Stripe. So they have a pretty amazing user base, and you might have seen them in a variety of websites as well. The only problem with them is their onboarding process. They still work on the manual physical papers. You have to send the couriers and files and back and forth. So the onboarding process is a pain, and it might take months to get onboarded there. Pricing, very competitive. Documentation, absolutely amazing. In fact, a lot of blogs and articles are there to integrate in almost any tech stack. The payment option, they provide you like insane amount of options in the payment options. User interface, okay, 3 stars there, not much impressed with their user interface. The reports, pretty dope. They are just the big dogs in the industry. The one that I absolutely love to work with is the Braintree. It's a PayPal subsidiary company, and I would say their integration, documentation, everything is absolutely good, but it's not really that much friendly in India. It mostly works with the credit card, and if you're looking up for United States-based e-commerce only, then I think Braintree is a pretty good way of having it. It supports all the Visa, PayPal, Venmo, Apple Pay. So it's moreover focused on the United States, but still I wanted to mention it because working with them is absolute fun. So if you get a chance to work with them in any project or something, just take that experience. It's totally worth it. Now finally, I would also mention this 2Checkout. Now for the 2Checkout, I won't be comparing it on each and every criteria like onboarding and pricing and everything. I would say their pricing and everything is decent, very competitive. Their onboarding process is a little bit difficult still. You will face a lot of troubles and documentation back and forth in that. It's not very easy to go on there. Documentation, okay-ish. Not really much impressed with that. It definitely could be improved. Their user interface is not something that I loved it absolutely. Payment option, they provide you a lot of options. But the thing which is a little bit tricky is into their products. So if you look out their product, they have 2Sell, 2Subscribe, 2Monetize, and each of them are like having different pricing options. Makes me a little bit confused that what really is going on there. So that's why I didn't enjoy much of that here. Now, surely, these are not the complete or entire list of the payment gateways which are available. There are more ways of it, of integrating payment gateways. So in case you are using any other than these ones, please let me know in the comment section. I would definitely love to check out more of the payment gateways. Now, here's a side note, since you have watched the entire video, I would say that as quickly as you get a chance of interacting with any payment gateway or integrating or coding for that, please go ahead and take that experience. It's absolutely worth it. It sets you totally apart from a regular developer who is just designing websites with login and sign-in. Payment gateway is absolutely tricky and the most top-notch thing that you can do. So go ahead, take that experience. The video is pretty long, but hey, anyways, too much of information was there and I just wanted to do it in one video. That's it for this video, and let's catch up in the next one.